I just want to say one thing before we start our medical this thing. I think for me, this has been a story of woman power. And I'll tell you why I believe this is woman power. Because I was completely amazed that this lady sitting on over here, she might look and speak very little, but she's as bigger a hero than anybody I've seen. For 25 years, think about moving a 500 kilo person up and down 4 to 5 times a day without having one bed sore. We shuttle things when we have to look after our parents or our grandparents just for a few years when they're not even that heavy. And she's looked after her sister for 25 years, and I've never seen a better hero in real life than her. And to think about it, think of Iman. Iman's not moved at all. If you get, you saw the images, she lies there and people have to feed her. For me, that was one moment when I saw that, I said I have to help her. Because a lot of people said, why are you helping her? Why are you going out this whole thing? She's so high risk. If you technically were to calculate, I just calculated just now before coming here, her BMI works out to 252. Now the normal BMI is 24. She's 252, so if that is her BMI, you can imagine what we are facing on the way up. But inshallah, with all your prayers and everybody's prayers, I think we will come out trumps. It's like a journey which, as you saw, the amount of preparations that we did, and I do know that quite often the Indian media was so anticipating for Iman to come here, they sometimes were upset with us that we didn't live up to our promises and whatever. But please understand, we were just trying to do this to make sure that she came as safe as possible. Because we couldn't have had even one tiny little thing go wrong in this whole journey, because that would have not gone our breath. For me to also say that this whole thing that has happened, as we say, pichar bhi baaki hai mere dost. So we've got to start my whole journey. And I never actually thought that after doing all this, I would still have to start my journey. And now my journey starts, and it's going to be a really difficult journey. So if you can see my entire army of people around me, that's the reason I've armed myself. These are some of the best people trained in their own specialties and who helped me out of a lot of difficult situations to come out. So to start with, I can just tell you that, like I said, Iman's BMI works out to around 252. She's at 141 centimeters. And what we believe is that she needs a lot of care. So right now she's struggling with hypertension, she's got hypothyroidism, she's got gout, she's got diabetes, early diabetes, she's got sleep apnea, which is very severe, and she's got certain pressure sores medically or certain parts of her body which are dependent on touching the ground because of the weight. She's got a lot of fluid overload in her system, and our job right now is to first look, because nobody else in our family is that obese. First and foremost, we are going to rule out a host of genetic medical disorders which might have caused her to put on so much weight. She's also, as I was told initially, that she's got a stroke and her right hand and legs don't move. But now we've realized after she comes here that she can move them. She actually can move them. That's why I got Dr. Arun Shah on board. And he'd probably be able to tell you better into how soon we can get her to recover and whether the recovery will be full. We'll be starting on after the investigations, which are most of them have come. The most important thing is to try and get off all the fluid overload that she has. Right now, Iman, if you feel the skin, doesn't feel like normal skin. It feels as hard as stone. And that's the problem we are facing. So we have to get all this fluid out, and that's the challenge that they are going to face. After the fluid comes out, only then, after the genetic tests and all come down, and we can stabilize on all fronts, will we actually be thinking whether to do bariatric surgery or not. That is around at least 4 weeks from now, nothing before that. And I hope that y'all don't get disappointed if we don't tell you when we're going to operate on it. Okay? Because I want the family to have their own privacy, Iman to have her own space, and for us, most importantly, to have not too much pressure on us when we are operating on her, because we will have to operate at some point in time. But we will inform you. We will inform you, and y'all will come to know. But just allow us that little bit. Don't get disappointed if we don't tell you, because we can't keep updating you on every single thing that happens with Iman, because the road is not very straight and clear. please, please give them their privacy because they are our guests, and let's India treat them as our guests. In terms of medical reports, anything else that you would like to ask? We're here, the team is here to answer your questions, and we'll take it forward from there.